Hi, fourth grade. I hope you all are doing well. This is going to be lesson two from the chapter on the kings of Israel and Judah. Actually, this will be lesson two and three. All right. So, if you remember, the kingdoms split. So, what you're looking at now is the kingdom of Israel. So, after Solomon, the kingdom of Israel is right there. And you'll notice in the key, the red shows all the kings that were evil and nothing but evil. The gray shows the kings that were good and evil, and the white shows the kings that were all good. As you can see, there's a lot of red in Israel. Before we start talking about Ahab, we remember how many of those kings got to be king because they killed off the next king. So some of them didn't last very long. We're going to see that again here toward the end. The last one we stopped after Ahab, there was a couple of, it was a son and a grandson that made it. And then Jehu became the king of Israel. And if you remember, Jehu could have been the one and only good king. He did right. He did what he was supposed to do. The prophet told him to kill off all of the family, all the males out of Ahab's family. And Jehu did exactly what he was told to do. He got rid of the Baal worship. He was on his way to being a great king. And then he decided, no, I think I'm going to worship some false gods. And he messed himself up. But he did do some right things. So the prophet had told him, I would have established your throne just like I did David. But because you chose to walk away from me, now only four generations. So Jehu's son, his grandson, his great-grandson, and his great-great-grandson would be king. But after that, no more of Jehu's family would be king. So here we have the four generations. Jehoahaz, his son, Jehoash, his grandson, Jeroboam, yeah, another one by that name, his great-grandson, and Zechariah, his great-great-grandson, became kings of Israel, or became kings of Judah, excuse me. No, sorry, it was Israel, became kings of Israel. And they lasted pretty well. None of them were good kings, though. Not one of his family were good kings. They had been warned along with every king of Israel that had come along that if they didn't turn from their sin, God was going to remove his blessing from them and allow the Assyrians to come in and take them captive. But these guys didn't listen at all. In fact, the last one, Zechariah, he only made it to be king for 6 months before the next king came along. Now, one interesting thing during the time of Jehoash, Elisha the prophet had actually died, and they buried him. But when the Assyrians came to try to attack some people who were having a funeral, they decided to quickly put the person's body that had died into Elisha's grave. And when the dead body touched the dead body of Elisha, it jumped up and came back to life again. So that was kind of an interesting thing that happened during that king's reign. And as I said, the last in Jehu's family was killed after only 6 months of being king, and Shalom became king. And then we're going to see that crazy pattern start again that we saw before Ahab. Shalom was king for 1 month, and then he was killed by Menahem. And Menahem was a bad king. He actually paid the Assyrians not to attack. So every so often he'd send some money to the king of Assyria so they wouldn't attack. Menahem's son actually made it to the throne, Pekahiah. Pekahiah made it 2 years before the next guy came along, Pekah. And Pekah also a bad king. By the time it got to this guy, the Assyrians were ready to attack. And Pekah was killed not too long after he became king by the last king of Israel, which was Hoshea. And right after Hoshea is when the Assyrians came and captured Israel and took them away. Okay, so basically every king of Israel was bad. The closest one that came to being somewhat good was Jehu. Okay, then we have the other side. This is the kings of Judah. These are the ones in David's family. Remember, God had promised David that there would always be one of his descendants on the throne. So these guys pretty much follow grandson, great-grandson, great-great-grandson all the way down. But look here at the key at the bottom. Remember, red, always evil. Gray starts out pretty good and then turns evil. And white were the ones that were good before God. And you can see in this list, even in the kings of Judah, only two of them followed God all their lives. Others started out good. Here's Joash, the one we talked about the last time, who was good up until Jehoiada, the priest, died. And then Joash went and worshiped false gods too. So after Joash came a guy by the name of Amaziah, his son. Amaziah was an okay king. He followed God, sort of, but the false worship remained there. After Amaziah died, then a guy by the name of Ahaziah, his son, became the king. Ahaziah did a little bit worse than his father did. Sometimes they call Ahaziah Uzziah. And he actually started out as a good king. And then he got very prideful and decided he was a fabulous king and he could do whatever he wanted to do. So he decided he was going to go into the temple and offer incense to the Lord. The priests all said, no, don't do it. He says, I am the king. I'll do what I feel like. So he went into the temple and began to offer incense. And God gave him leprosy on his forehead, which was a terrible, awful disease. That was his punishment. Then after Ahaziah died, his son Jotham became king. Jotham was okay. He did some good stuff. He sometimes worshiped God, but he was a weak king. He did not stop the false worship. He did not stand up and say, no, we're not going to do this. He was sort of the weak, go-along, get-along type of king. And so as a result, when he died, his son Ahaz became the king of Israel. And Ahaz was not even pretending to follow God. Ahaz said, that's it. I do what I want. I am the king. I will worship Baal. I will worship any false god I feel like. And as a result, God did allow the Assyrians to have some victory over Judah. So Ahaz took the same idea that the king in Israel had, which is, let's pay. We'll pay the Assyrians not to attack us. Now let's see, where can I come up with a whole bunch of gold and silver to pay the king of Assyria not to attack us? Oh, I know. How about the temple? God's temple. Remember when Solomon had built the temple, the inside walls of the temple were covered in gold. The things were made of gold and silver and all kinds of wonderful things. What you're looking at here is what they called the sea. This was just a place to put water, and the priests could wash their hands and their feet after they sacrificed. So Ahaz commanded that they pull this gold and the silver out of the temple, pull it down from the walls, break up the pieces that had been built of gold and silver, and break it into little pieces and put it on carts and give it to the king of Assyria so he would not attack. You can imagine by the time Ahaz was not king anymore, he had died and done evil in God's sight. The next king, his son Hezekiah, had quite a mess on his hands. Now Hezekiah was a good king. If you look back at that list, he was one of the ones in white. So Hezekiah became the king of Israel. He saw all the evil and wickedness that his father had done. And the first thing he did as king was to get that temple back the way it was supposed to. Pay the workers, give them supplies to get the temple all cleaned up, fixed up, nice looking again, and then get the worship of God back in Judah. And as a result, God blessed Hezekiah. God was very pleased with Hezekiah, and we're going to see some stories about how God took care of Hezekiah and blessed him for following God and for turning away. He got rid of the false worship in Israel and Judah and followed God. All right, so for now, guys, you can go back and read 2 Chronicles 29 and do the worksheet on Hezekiah cleanses the temple. And I will see you the next time. Bye-bye.